Good evening, everybody. Thank you so much for joining us either here live in the chapel or what I'm sure are World Cup soccer breaking legions of fans joining us online, both live and in the future, wherever you are. It's truly a privilege to be here, to be giving live performances in front of live human beings. This is the sort of the end of our winter term here at Lawrence, for those of you who aren't familiar. And we actually got a little bit of a late start on our term two with the 2 week remote only. So this has been a lot of music to get together in a somewhat compressed time, and I'm so as always continually amazed at the work that the students of this ensemble do every day, every rehearsal, every cycle. So this concert is a little bit of a combination of some various programming themes and motivations here as we go. Part of what I wanted to do tonight was present some music from movies, soundtracks, and that sort of that genre. One of my favorite movies of all time is the Alfred Hitchcock North by Northwest, and Bernard Herrmann's very famous opening credit sequence that in some ways depicts both the hustle and bustle of mid-20th century New York City and the rather frenetic chase sequences that go through the life of Cary Grant and Roger Thornhill as mistaken identity leads him to the middle of Indiana and South Dakota and all kinds of different places. In a slightly different vein, our second piece is from a more recent film and a very different type of genre. This is, students who know a lot more about this than I do say it kind of depends on how you frame it, define it, and who you ask whether this movie Spirited Away is anime or not. And without starting any particular fights or battles, we'll just say it's a really, really beautiful animated film. And the music that has been taken and adapted to the wind ensemble medium is really, really beautiful and stunning. I also want to take one quick second to recognize, even though this is sort of the middle of our year, we have a student who will be studying abroad next term, so this is her last wind ensemble concert. So I'd like to just welcome, thank you, and recognize Kylie Zidell.
Thank you.
Just to say a few things kind of about both our pieces, last two pieces together in one block. Our next piece, the Yo Goto Lacrimae, was actually a piece that was initially scheduled to be performed last November. And literally the day before the concert, we had a tremendous spike in COVID, and we could have probably done the concert with maybe about 12 people that were left between either positive tests or proximity or whatever the heck we call those things. So that canceled. So this was the this is actually our second concert of the whole year as well. Our last one was in October. So the pieces that we were initially scheduled to perform in November were kind of rescheduling, and this is one of them. I also want to say just a quick word before I dive into the Lacrimae. Our final piece features an amazing soloist, Ava Ordman from Michigan State University. I want to thank Tim Albright, our trombone professor, for setting up that residency, bringing Ava to our campus, having it work out for her to perform this piece with the wind ensemble. She's been a very busy person all week, working with lots of different kinds of students, not just trombonists. And it's just been a real treat to have her. And it's also one of those things when she was here, it's like, oh yeah, that's what it's like to have people on campus. Oh yeah, that's pretty cool. I also want to just give a shout out to Wisconsin native David Biedenbender. This is an amazing piece. Ava herself described it as more than a concerto and actually like a symphony for trombone and wind ensemble. So that's our closer. And the three movements actually depict the composers at that time that he was writing this very young children. Beginnings pretty much says it all about his very youngest son, who was, I think, two at the time. This song, Makes My Heart Not Hurt, is the second movement of the concerto, which was a phrase uttered by his older son at dinner when they were just trying to process a passing in the family. And he was listening to a piece of music, and those are the words he said, and that struck David as a pretty beautiful sentiment for a young child's vision into what music can do. And then Isaac's control panels, anyone who's had young children knows what this is all about. A shoebox plus some buttons and whatever's lying around turns into a control panel for a spaceship or whatever. And that's the third movement of the trombone concerto. So about our next piece, Yo Goto is actually also a Japanese composer. Lacrimae is a reference to John Dowland's Lacrimae, same title, translated loosely as Seven Tears. This is written about 400 years ago. And what I love about this piece is it's a very modern treatment of some really one of the longest lasting melodies that we have. I also think it's a fitting tribute. And as I stand on this stage, and every time I come on this stage, whether it's a Friday afternoon rehearsal or a concert or anything, I'm struck by the beauty of this place. The stained glass windows, the sheer, just you can tell that a lot of things have happened in this place over the last 100 plus years now that it's been in existence. And I also want to be mindful of the fact that there are lots of parts of the world that don't have the luxury of celebrating the same kind of beauty. And John Dowland himself wrote that the tears which music weeps can be pleasant. Neither are tears shed always in sorrow, but sometimes in joy and gladness. And to me, this says a lot about this piece, because I think sometimes it's easy to take for granted what we are able to do. And in my mind, I would like to suggest that we're not making music and creating art and sharing what it means to be human in obliviousness to what's going on the other side of the world or down the street. We can recognize the fact that even though we have this privilege to enjoy beauty, and there is a tyrant trying to destroy lives and at least disrupt lives, and that as we recognize that and honor that, we also use this music to explore more deeply, perhaps, what it means to be human through the sharing of musical art and beauty to celebrate humanity's peaks and better equip us to endure its valleys. And I think our next piece is a beautiful expression of that. So I hope you'll enjoy Yogoto's Lacrimae. And then following that, our wonderful conclusion and our solo, Abe Wortman.
Thank you. Thank you. Uh-huh.